We have come almost end of the session. Now last lecture is by Professor K R Sridhara Murthy.
Inclusive Manufacturing Forum is a great idea. It is really strengthening to be among this very august gathering who have single commitment, the commitment to find inclusive solutions. I have spent 3.5 decades in Indian Space Research Organization, in the organization which had great ethos for applying space technology for inclusive development. So today, based on the experience of large number of societal applications which ISRO has pursued, I have taken three problems and three simple examples and analyzed how we could go forward. One of the greatest problem is the spatial dimension of the disparities or inequities. This has come out strikingly in several presentations. Essentially, if we take just one of the very important aspect, that is the healthcare problem. The 67% of our population today is in rural areas, whereas only 3% of the specialists are accessible in rural areas. There are good reasons for this, but today the model is any rural person needing attention for specialist care has to come to the urban area, wait, spend a lot of money, and it's great problem of access. So this is one of the disparity. The second striking problem that we see is the working in silos in several organizations, particularly in government, we experience, and it's not only in government, even in society, we see this behavior. Whereas we need to optimally use resources, and many of the resources are interrelated. If we talk about water problem, water as a resource is connected to several aspects, other aspects of environment. So we need a holistic look when we talk about sustainable use of resource, optimal use of a resource. And this is still a big problem when we talk of inclusive development. The third problem that we notice is the timely interventions for empowerment. This is limited by connectivity issues. Today we know that we have solutions. We need access to the people, and we have wonderful technologies which can solve these problems. In the urban environment, probably it is easier for us. But when we talk of India inclusive development issues, there are still 700 million people, rural population, are not connected through internet. Although great strides are being made, already about 130 million people are connected through internet in rural areas, and there are plans that within a few years plans to cover the entire rural population. What is to be noted here, it is not one single technology, one single approach that can achieve this objective. There will always be last mile problems. So we need to think of a combination of technologies and approaches to provide that comprehensive access solution. So let us take the first problem, the problem of disparity of availability of experts and the need. One of the cases we considered very early on, almost at the beginning of 2000, with the help of Apollo Hospital and also Dr. Devi Shetty, is to think of telemedicine, which connects the rural population with the experts, medical experts. It was emphatically said by Dr. Devi Shetty, of all the cases which don't require surgical intervention, there is no need for the physical presence of the patient. So this was one of the revealing opportunities, and you know, we started telemedicine experiments using space technology, and of course with a lot of help from several other organizations like hospitals, specialists, and then also software developing companies and so on and so forth. Today we carried these experiments for a quite long time and accumulated very good experience, and many private sector hospitals have taken this as their mission and became part of this exercise, and some of them today independently they are carrying out this. This has a great potential to reduce that unreached rural people who need attention of the specialists, but they are not able to do that. And the experience shows us this technology is quite helpful, because today we have wonderful softwares, data processing methods, networking methods, communication technologies, which can transfer without any loss the information from patient end to the specialist end. And this is possible. Based on this, we have these services rendered from any part. Now, today technology permits you to choose any specialist hospital wherever you are located and connect to the specialist and get the advice of the specialist. So here you can see the connection between the offshore islands and hospital in Chennai. And sometimes if Chennai hospital specialist is not available, they can connect to Bombay or any other specialist hospital. This is possible today with today's technology. But the question is how to extend it to the national level proportion. The project mode of telemedicine has to become a mainstream telemedicine activity to be able to provide service. The issues today we have, which is preventing this kind of a complete scale up, is the need for standards, interoperability, and what is there for the doctors to adopt this methodology. As a philanthropic activity, many hospitals, they have made it as a corporate strategy to do that, and it is going on. But we need a very definite incentive system. Probably the government has to have a scheme for this. If we have to dream that, you know, this technology is made accessible to the large chunk of population, irrespective of where rural population or remote population are located. And it is also possible to use horizontal networks like community networks. They are great in sharing the experience. Today we need to use the power of that. And of course, medical service is always, it is a responsible service. We need a certain amount of regulation and adaptation for the telemedicine related activity. The second problem is relating to this, how to overcome the silos mode of working. Here, fortunately, very eminent public servant like Dr. Meenakshi Sundaram is there, who have given us tremendous strength, encouragement to undertake the projects like this, bringing in the various stakeholders together. So this is a watershed development project which was assisted by World Bank. So we took up initially this project in 5 semi-arid districts of Karnataka: Kolar, Dharwad, Haveri, Chitradurga, Tumkur, but now 2 more districts are added. This project has been conducted over a period of 10 years to test the sustainability and how the community adapts. This is essentially a community-driven project, but empowered by the technology. So our responsibility was to independently monitor the process and evaluate the impact. We have used the most modern technology, like space technology, to study the resources, to evolve scientific action plans, but these action plans were given to the community. The community, you can see here, they prepared natcha and discussed, because the land is owned by individuals. They have to implement. So they discussed, they modified the plan, bringing in their own knowledge, considerations, interests, and so on. And a software is developed so that this information system made the whole thing very transparent. We recruited very young students coming out of college, and they went and verified in the field to check whether at synoptic level we could monitor through space, but it was necessary to also cross-check with ground observations. These young people, without any kind of baggage, they could do a wonderful job. So here, NGOs were involved in implementation and in capacity building of the communities. There are other considerations like income generating activities, gender equity were all considered, and the self-help groups, executive committees were formed in the villages themselves. They took stake in the project. So at the end of the project, we could very well demonstrate, when we looked at the objectives. The objectives of this project was to increase the production potential of the land resources in terms of soil quality, surface water quality, groundwater levels, and so on. So the agricultural production, income levels, employment, whole host of things, what we heard in some of the other presentations, were part of the evaluation process. And we could demonstrate, when we work together, go beyond the silos, when we integrate using the technologies. GIS is a wonderful technology, and you can see the many layers of resources analyzed rationally. So when we do this, results were there. So essentially, there are many lessons we learned. If we use these lessons, certainly we can scale it up to the national level. The third part is, within our own country, we could demonstrate that, you know, we could make a satellite which could distribute internet. This was exported. So today we have this problem of rural connectivity for internet. So there is urgent need. But you may have a question: what is the relation between inclusive manufacturing and, you know, having a satellite? Satellite is at high end, but what it will trigger is a large number of, since internet is going to be delivered to the homes, there are hundreds of millions to be serviced through such system, at least several millions to start with. It will be a wonderful opportunity for industry to produce the ground terminals, ground related technologies. So several inclusive manufacturing opportunities can be opened up apart from addressing the basic connectivity problem. Thank you.